Hi guys, YXM here, everyone's favorite YouTuber who stutters and mispronounces everything. Gotcha. It's just me, man. Whitefield Vinyl back. First off, Wyatt, thank you so much for shouting me out. It helps with the subscriber count. Kinda went up. Not in the numbers you guys have, but lucky to get what I can get. So yeah, thank you for that, man. Really appreciate it. I'm sorry about the impression. Hope I did you right. I have a new update for you guys. Vinyl and tapes only, as per usual. Let's get into it, because it's been a while since I did an update, so there's pretty much a lot going on. I'll put my hat back on for a while for this one. Little Ugly Mane with a Mr. Tuck Isolation. This is a re-release from, I don't think it's his debut album, but an earlier record of his. This is a trap artist, hip-hop artist, with some rough edges. The front and the back. It is on. Is it on records? I'm not sure what it's released on. We ordered it with a couple of guys, so I didn't do it. It's on H and something else. So yeah, a little of the name. There is this nice positive insert with a guy hanging himself. And then the vinyl is a double poisonous clear yellow. Yola. Yeah, it's trap. It's a heavier, darker hip-hop records with a banana sleeve. So that's the first thing I got in this update. A little out of the comfort zone, maybe, for the other listeners. That one can go, which is a cool cat, though. Yo, MTV Raps, remember that time. On the record player is maybe a little silent. But it is the draped in the obsidian black cloak of the abyss, Basmu, Bach Phantom, this project, which keeps growing on me and keeps getting better and better and better. Fleur du Mal has his tapes. These are the self-released ones. They have his tapes and a shirt. Our man is blowing up. A shirt available to purchase. So check it out. Very, very lo-fi, cavernous. Straight from the White Nords, black metal. Cheers. Okay, on to the next stuff. There is a flea market every Saturday, which I never went to because I know they have tons of good records and I already buy too much. But we were there Saturday, it's in my hometown, and I picked up three releases, which I'm going to go through rather fastly because, yeah, we'll see. Kristen Dead Ashes. I was looking for the first one, of course, but I got this instead because they didn't have it. Really good prices, the guy. Yeah, he had really good prices, nothing more, nothing less. This is a little bit less good than the earlier records, but still there are really good songs in here, especially Side 2. The last track on Side 1 is maybe one of the worst things I ever heard. So yeah. A bit of an older record from Normal Records, Christian Dead with Ashes. And then, this is what grabbed my attention in the first place. This is Alcoholic Rites. Yeah, the cover reminded me of kind of an aesthetic, a label I loved, and then it turned out to be, it was on Iron Bonnet. This is a very early Iron Bonnet one. I don't see a year on here. No. Anyway, Alcoholic Rites, a duo, which is still active, I think, because they have a split brought out in 2006. I just blind bought it. I don't know anything about these guys. I looked up where they're from, but I already forgot. So, you know, a lyrics sheet. But it was on Iron Bonnet, so how bad can it be? It is a black record with a blood side and a alcohol side. So yeah, it It's kind of the police intoxications thing that they have going on also. Yeah, trashy black metal. Really, not really early, but early for the wave. Limited to 500 copies, I guess. It is still floating around somewhere. Work with me. And then this was kind of a lucky find. It's a bit beat up, but this is the Triumph of Evil, Witness to the Bringer of Life's Decay, a tribute to Judas Iscariot from a while ago. I'm not sure how long it's been, but it's been a while. Let me look up the Discogs entry. This is a yeah, a compilation of, I wouldn't say like-minded bands that cover songs from them. This is from 2007, and this is readily available, so it's not Spencer or something like that. It has Xastro on it, it has Leviathan, and then, of course, more more obscure stuff like Arkenstone and Birkenau, which is kind of questionable in my opinion, but okay. Creek is on here, Machtig from Holland, yeah, check out. Keep it as still as possible. I don't think that will be readable, but anyway, it is, like I said, kind of beat up, but for the price I got it, I couldn't pass this one up on a sunny Saturday. There's a complete release list there, and it is a black double-sided two records, just in one sleeve, not a gatefold. But yeah, I saw that, and how many times can you say you find something like this on a flea market, so I had to pick that up. That was the start of a good day. Then, let's see what we have here. I got lucky, and I got the re-release of Moons Melek Taus, T-A-U-S, on Skjold. Everybody who is into this kind of records and kind of music knows that this is nearly impossible to get, because he always releases at 5 in the morning or something, and yeah, I'm asleep then. I don't know where they're from, maybe the time zone there is a bit better for it, but yeah. The third release by Skjold, I think? No, second release. Once again, it is a kind of bare bones release, like they always do. I have a Blood Tyrant and the Sanguine Relic stuff. It is the same kind of thing with a flap, screen printed. Oh, that's accepted. Like this, and then the back. It is perfect. It doesn't need anything more. It is sturdy cardboard, so I'm good with it. But yeah, it's not a full sleeve record. A, B, C, D on black. Nice labeling there. And like I said, it you have to be on the mark to get those Skjold records, because they don't normally show up in distros other than maybe a few on Iron Bonnet. But yeah, it's good that they re-released, because this is second pressing, so maybe the rest will be re-released too. Who knows? Which will be good. I'm an advocate for keeping records in pressing, especially when you're doing 122 or something like that. Then, Eternal Champion. I missed the show. They did a house show not long ago. My friends, Axel the X-Man, went to the show, and they were all raving about it. This is pure Nwabun worship. Just everything you would expect from looking at the cover, and then some. So yeah, I would say it's war metal, but not like Diocletian or Blasphemy or whatever. It's war metal in the Lord of the Rings way, rather than falling bombs, destruction, and end of the world. Cool little release. It is more of a novelty for me than a serious record. It is on black, released on a label in Portugal, and on No Remorse Records. So yeah, Eternal Champion. Check it out if you're into that new album. But yeah, it's a little bit more current than, of course, than the new album. But yeah, that's kind of the sound they're going for. That heroic, storm the castle stuff. Then the same X-Men, we did a bundle order with hypertension, and I kind of slept on these records because I was going to go for the lavish editions, of course, from Van Records, but too lavish is like 100 euros or $100, so I just opted for the regular one. This is the Instant Wounds of Everest collection. Like I said, I was holding out for the lavish edition, but I didn't have the money to buy all the stuff and just opted for the regulars, which are pretty cool in their own way, maybe even cooler because the artwork is bigger on there. This is the first one, and it is called Blood, not the first one, but the first one I have, Blood Falls, The Blazing Gospel of Heinrich Kramer, and then Cryptae Sanguinum Evangelium and stuff. It's too long. Yeah, this is the record from, what year is this? I think maybe 5 years ago now. Let's check it out. This is how I got to know him with this record. We went to a gig in Brussels that had Urk Faust and Bozic, and they also played, so that's where I got to meet him. 2013, wow, time flies. So yeah, that's about 5 years, that's great. Gatefolds. And yeah, this is, if you haven't heard this, it's kind of hard to describe. It is the guy from Knucklefar that also had Sven from Fan Records in there, an earlier black metal band from Holland. Influences from that band crept into the Ruins of Beverest, but this is a lot more. This is more expansive, this is more styles of music involved into it, and it's just really, really, really worth checking out, in my opinion. So yeah, if you don't know him, do yourself a favor and check him out today. Malleus Maleficarum, The Witch Hammer. It is on a blue, nice clear vinyl, both of them are. I opted for the colors on these because, yeah, the artwork is matching the stuff. There were a lot of extra sleeves, don't know what that's good for. But that's the first one. Then the second one I got was the EP that came out before the last record, and this is Takitun Totem. A really nice screen print. This is on silver tone on a rockstock black simple sleeve. It has Takitun Totem War Dance and then Set Controls to the Heart of the Sun from that other band we know and love. It is the clear vinyl version, and it comes with a sturdy insert for the detail of the artwork, and of course a poster of the artwork by them. So yeah, really nice releases always. I haven't heard this one. This is a earlier version of a song that is on the new record, and then the cover, but I haven't made it to this one yet. But a very, very good pressing, a smoky clear, but the smoke is also clear. So, very nice releases again by them, and I already have a new order coming in from them. I was hoping to get the Urfaust limited one from the Acherontic Arts Fest, but I didn't make it to the festival, so yeah, but yeah. Then, The Beast. This is Eruvia, the newest one that just got released in time for the fest. Gatefold, nothing much to see in there, but this is a unbelievable record. I mean, there is so much going on that it's even harder to describe the first records, and dig into their earlier stuff. I mean, it is quite a band that will keep you going on for a while. Once again, poster, of course. There is a, against the sleeve, there is a booklet with more artwork and lyrics. And like I said, Van, I mean, they always go beyond what is capable of with records, and their prices are actually very democratic in my opinion. This is the clear red with the black smoke in there. This is a color that is quite popular because I have a lot of records on this color. Mr. Min is one of them, for example. But yeah, like I said, this is a beast of a record. There are 6 tracks on here. Some of them reach the mark of like 12 minutes, 15 minutes. So check them out. Ruins of Belrest with Eruvia. I hope I'm pronouncing that. Yeah, Eruvia. Check it out. Then, let's see, a few more records. I went to the Possession release show in Brussels last weekend, and New Era and Amafati Distros were there. Don't ask. Yeah, you should. And yeah, I picked some stuff up. I didn't go to the Amafati Distro because it was crazy. I already had Possession stuff, so nothing to buy there. But this popped up. This is the 4-way split between, I know a lot of people showed it, like Wyatt showed it and Canyon showed it, but it took me a while to order it because I was like, yeah, it's everywhere and I'll get it one day, but then it was sold out everywhere. This is on Darker Than Black. Nice glossy sleeve. Not too keen on the artwork. It looks like it's a detail from a larger stuff, but it's okay. I got it for AMSG and Svoldig. I don't know too much about Hostium and Elegance. What I heard people describe them by, it's not really awesome, but yeah, to each their own. Very anti-religion, as you can see, not just Christianity, but Judaism, Islamic, anti-Islamic. And especially Svoldig, which has the Prophet Muhammad on guitars and vocals. Yeah, please ISIS don't bomb my channel. Faggots. I can say that word against them because nobody can use that word, it is so bad. This is on black. Just a simple black record, and there are a lot of tracks on here. I think it's the Arrogance part of the split that has like a billion tracks on there. Yeah, it's Arrogance, gotta be Arrogance. But I don't see a track list popping up anywhere, so yeah. Cool split, especially the AMSG. Then two more records. There is the Cavern record. I have the Necropole coming in, and then Cavern caught my attention also because I got a flyer in there in a previous order, which between the glossy flyers that stood out because it was a drenched in coffee ruined flyer, and then when I looked at it, it had, was the same as the Necropole stuff. Here's the flyer, just crackled. Gonna change the tape for a minute here. Thank you. Now we are playing Gidim, the first demo, crappy cardboard. Second one came out on Fallowfield, I think. So yeah, Cavern, a French entity, black metal band with some very folkish influences. There is a straight up folk song on here. Don't know too much about it. It is a co-release between Northern Heritage and, sorry, Tresilience. It comes with this booklet, Aux Frontières du Monde. Frontières, is it borders? Yeah, borders of the world. Lyric booklet, but it is mostly in French. All of it is in French. There we go. So yeah, the re-releases of the earlier records are kind of hard to come by, but this is really readily available. Nice looking sleeve, a fiberish cardboard-esque sleeve with a beautiful detailed screen print on it, and then the back. I love stuff like this, which seems like it's kind of handmade. The record itself is a black, but really good pressing, really thick, nice pressing. Northern Heritage always has really good stuff in my opinion. Nice poly lined inner. So yeah, a good package for that price. And like I said, this is still available, but I'm not sure how much longer this will be available. So if you're into that kind of music, if you're into the kind of style and stuff like Nick Popol, which is, I'm pretty sure it's the same guy, pick this up, Cavern. Of all of his records, this one has been on the turntable the most. And then last and motherfucking certainly not least, since this is a dedicated to Wyatt video, I had to put in my first Go to Warx record. I knew New Era had this, but on the side it was last copy. I still think they have one, but it's a damaged corner, so I never pulled the trigger on the side. But then they had it in distro. This is Planet 8 with a 8 Apocalyptic. There we go. This is a project from... Damn, this is some time ago, but I'll have to check what year it is. I don't know very much about this, except for the fact that the guy, Jimmy Blitzer, or Jim the Doctor, or whatever his name, the drummer for Hochfaust is in here. This is from 2013 also, released in China, but this is a Dutch band that does really slow drone pieces, like a bit like Sun maybe, but more like Conate, or yeah, in that realm, the darker drone, the heavy aesthetic drone bands, drone pieces. Manuel Tinnemans, again, he keeps popping up in my collection, did the artwork. And this is the red final edition, limited to 100 copies. And then, because of that busted corner, they gave me a cool discount at the gig. So yeah, nice red vinyl to round off this video. Like I said, this is I expected a more faster black metalish sound, but this is really slow doomy stuff on the Go to Warx records. This is from 2004, injected at ground zero. They kind of have this druggish vibe going on. There was a Die Hard with a huge Nazi-esque style flag and some injection needles. So yeah, it's a good vibe all around. That was the last one, Planet 8. If you want one, I think New Era has one. Maybe with a slightly heavier dinged corner, but worth it in my opinion. Really good record. Let's check for time. Sorry. 22. Let's do the tapes, because there's not really much to say about them. Otherwise I have to do a second video and there's some stuff coming in. First is Oud en Bezeten, Old and Possessed, on a Hedens Hart Records. I got this at New Era 2, this is the last one I got. This is limited edition, your copy is 666, but it's actually limited to 100. Black tape. And this is a compilation of early Dutch black metal bands. Here is the lineup, Zwarte Plaag. What else is on here? Yeah, really readable lyrics. Funeral Winds, Inferi, and other stuff like that. Yeah, don't know too much about it, other than that's practice demos and unreleased material, all exclusive to this tape. So it's a nice snapshot of Dutch black metal and black metal styles. Yeah, project. I'm going to have a lot of fun with this one, I think. It has a lineup right here: Domini, Inferi, Funeral Winds, Gol or Gull, Lugubre, Sauron, Rock, and Zwarte Plaag. Maybe that will show up. So yeah, cool little tape. Then I got these as soon as they popped up on Tour de Garde. This is the Shadow Kingdoms. Oh, sorry, Shadow Kingdoms. Forgotten Kingdoms. There are so many kingdoms. The Blue Moon Gates Between Worlds, and then Crowned in Forlorn Darkness. This is the first time they were released on an analog format, I think. I think this one for sure is on CD, but I don't know about the rest. Yeah, like I said, both limited to 100 copies.
and Odegaard. This is still available. I thought these would go a lot quicker. I ordered them last week and they're already here from Canada, so cheap shipping, cool tapes, and they have a new Drown Into the Light tape up for sale, and another which I'm blanking on that is really worth it. Then, two more. This is the Guy C1 with the Never Ending Knife in the Mind. It went up at the same time the Lampier 2 demo went up, which I terribly missed because I was asleep again. I sleep too much. This was out on Hateworks. The guy from Perverse Homage put it on the Facebook that that this was up, so I got it from the shop. It's on Hateworks, yeah. It comes in this cardboard wraparound box, and this is the actual tape. This one is limited to, I don't know, something in the 60 region. Yeah, 60. 46. And this is in the same vein as the entire Lampier Carrion. I'm blanking on the other name. The entire Vampire Sanguine Relic stuff. This is actually a compilation of all the demo material from these guys, the 1-5 demo. And it's pretty good. It's really lo-fi, but it's a really good tape that needs some more listening. But yeah, Never Ending Knife in the Mind. Then the last three, I just got this in this from the Shadow Kingdom, and it's called Ultima Thule with Enthralling Lunar Majesty. This was sold out in a blink. I got a heads up from Fastenrest. I'm not sure how to pronounce it on Instagram. We kind of have a dialogue going. I think he's on YouTube too, but he's not making videos. It starts out with a dungeon synthy sound and then evolves into black metal. I think they're from Netherlands, so it's another cool band from that circle, the Blood Tyrants stuff that they do with Shadow Kingdom. This is the photocopy J cards. Nothing much to see. Remnants of Burning Empires, yada yada yada, and they disappeared in the night. So yeah, you kind of know what this will sound like when I describe it like that. And then Ultima Thule, True. Pro duplicated cassette with multi-panel inlay, limited to 88, and then out soon on the Shadow Kingdom. And this came when the tape came, so yeah. It's out and it's sold out, because 88 tapes, let's be honest. Then, two more. I missed on the Youth Tech update. My Youth Tech order is still not here, but I managed to score these. This one on Discogs, this is Combat Force. Really cool band from Denver. This is their demo or first output. Three tracks: Kicking Heads, Comeback, Fight, Survive, and this is self-released. It is just a black tape. They are doing their full length on Youth Attack, maybe in a year or something. And then this Command, which I was looking forward to. This is a heavy hardcore tape, the rumor is these are members of Hoax, but don't quote me on that. Nice looking tape, and then they have a terror team going on in the inside of the sleeve. And if this is the first thing these guys are doing, yeah, this is going to be quite good. I managed to get the tapes in, guys. Kind of a large update, but it took a while for me to get it done. Tried once and it failed miserably. So yeah, next up I'm going to do one of those top 10 videos next. Maybe get a cool dialogue going, because yeah, I kind of enjoy doing those, like the top 20 discogs from Craig, and then a lot of others that were really cool. So yeah, thinking about that, doing that one, and then hopefully the Youth Attack comes in so I can do the unboxing. Guys, thank you so much for the new subscribers. Hope you like the channel. I got a lot of good comments, people who seem to like it, so yeah. Sorry, I used the word faggot. Bye. Yeah.